flat out. Big team, big boys, right?
My highs and lows inherit growth, Mr. Deeds. Went from jumping.
Once again, welcome back to another edition of Hot Takes. This is where me and John, we just look through what's trending, what's going on in the world today, and we give our thoughts and opinions on it. So first thing is, John, do you even moisturize?
Okay, before we go ahead and let me elaborate on this, okay? Let me elaborate on this. This may not be a trending topic, but we need to get our opinions out here. So when I had some of my friends visiting here recently in the UAE, we were getting ready in the morning, right? Trying to do our daytime activities. We'll get some brunch going on, you know, like whatever. And I told them, hold on. I need to sort of put lotion on my body. It's the last thing I do before I kind of like, you know, lotions on your arms, yeah, your body and stuff like that. Before we left. And they all looked at me and said, why do you do that? And I kind of looked at them like kind of bewildered and kind of confused. I was like, what do you mean? You don't moisturize your body? And they told me, no, I don't.
Hands, elbows, they don't put ankles.
They put no lotion on their body, aside from maybe on their face a little bit. So that's
these are grown men.
These are grown ass men. They're older than me, bro. Right? So they're grown ass men. So the first thing that came in my mind, I didn't even blame them. I was like, so your girlfriend touches your rusty, crusty ass body with no moisturization, and they're like, I don't care if my body's moisturized. So long as her body's moisturized. I was like, hold on. I live in a woman empowerment world.
Yeah.
I want my girl's body to be moisturized, I would hopefully assume I want my body to be soft and nice too. So I
and
don't,
they love it, first of all.
They love that they
when
take
you,
care of that.
When you if you a man and you take care of yourself, you smelling good, looking good, groom yourself. Oh man.
Manicure, pedicure.
Yeah. Your girl's gonna be all over you.
Over you, right?
Yeah.
So yes, I do moisturize to answer the question, mm-hmm, right? And I think it's extremely important to moisturize your body as a man.
Exactly.
Okay. None of this, like, have you heard those weird things about like men don't let water go in their backside because it'll
That's crazy
to me, bro. I'm like, what? That's nasty. But anyway, yes, I do moisturize, take care of my skin. How do you think this face looks like last, man, on this screen,
yeah,
right? How do you think our faces look so good? You think this comes naturally?
We got a routine, man. You got to have a skincare routine.
Yeah, exactly.
So, and
what about you?
Oh, I'm moisturized, man. I'm black, so I got to moisturize. It's going to be Ash City, you know what I mean? So,
you could salt your french fries with those.
You know, and depending on the temperature of the weather, it's like I got to throw in the oil with the lotion and all of that. So
you got to do the shape of the cocoa butter.
Any skincare brands, let us know. We're going to be the brand ambassadors.
Yeah, we'll be the brand ambassador. We're looking for skincare routines at the moment, man.
Exactly.
Okay, next hot take.
We got Jalen Green, 22 years old, Drea Michelle, 39 years old, having a baby. What's just your thoughts? Is it cool?
It's absolutely not cool. The same way that I guess women talk about how sometimes older men go after and prey on younger women. This is the reverse situation. What does a 39-year-old woman and a 22-year-old man have anything in common?
And she has a son his age.
And she has a son his age, right? Like, this is clearly.
But let me just first shout out Drea Michelle. I actually met her before. Just a picture. I didn't mean to have a conversation. But you know, hey, how you doing? Got a picture.
Yeah.
She is beautiful in person. So shout out to her. No, we're not bashing her necessarily.
We're talking about the situation.
Exactly. Situation.
We're not talking about the people. Right. We're talking about the situation.
Let's meet her.
No, what I'm saying is, but what does a 39-year-old have in common with a 22-year-old? Like, there's two different life spaces.
Yeah.
If you were having a conversation with your 22-year-old self, would you guys be able to have a long conversation
nothing
right now?
Nothing at all.
Right?
Nothing at all.
So for me, that situation is kind of like, it's hard to imagine that. Like, I mean, I can understand why the 22-year-old is doing it.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, she's kinda probably been on his wall.
Right, she's probably been on his wall, like, you know, whatever. But I don't understand if she can get Jalen Green, she could. I'm assuming that's.
Do you think it's a situation of she's in love or is it predatorial? Because this has been a thing, kind of. She's not the first to do this, you know. You have some older women going after these athletes and high profile. Celebrities.
I mean, without me knowing them, I mean, look, publicly we're gonna go by what they say publicly. She says she's in love, so I have to take her at face value, right?
Yeah.
Do I feel like there was another 22-year-old who was maybe less known, the bag was less small, would she be having his baby? I don't know.
Probably not.
Probably not. Probably not, right? But again, at the end of the day, I'm not criticizing women or men who want to be in certain relationships with certain people of status. That's not, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Stand on business.
Yeah.
But this situation on his face.
That age gap is.
That age gap is crazy.
Yeah.
Like, what? This guy is barely an adult. He hasn't even gotten through his rookie contract. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean?
Oh, man.
That baby's going to be well taken care of. Let's just put it that way. But do I feel like there's a little bit of, there's some side benefits that can come out of that? Of course, right? But I just think on its face, the situation's kind of ridiculous. It's not great. I really hope they're in love, but do I think it's gonna last? Probably not. Like, what is this, some Ashton Kutcher, Demi Moore type of situation? Yeah. Even they broke up, right? Like,
that's crazy. I mean, with these athletes, you wonder who are their mentors, because it seems like a lot of the young athletes are just getting caught up in certain situations. 22 years old, that's young.
Well, let me ask you something, Mike, for real. And you know what? We can talk about this till our face turns blue, but because we've never been in this situation, it's always easy to say, people are quick to say, I would never do this until they're in that situation. You know what? I don't have access to Andrea Michelle, so I don't know. If I was 22 years old with all this money and Andrea Michelle's coming actively pursuing me, how I would act.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So I don't want to go ahead and crucify Jalen Green for doing this or crucify Andrea Michelle for getting involved in this situation, but I would think that Jalen Green, there's programs in the NBA that they have mentors. And basketball players actively talk about this all the time.
Yeah.
Take care of your stuff. You never hear LeBron. You never hear Steph Curry, KD getting involved in this stuff, this type of stuff. Because they must have a good team around them.
They definitely do.
They have a great team around them to shield them from this kind of debauchery. And
LeBron is like the Obama of athletes.
He's
right,
the Derek Jeter. Yeah. Derek Jeter was running through half of New York City.
Yeah.
But you never hear anything bad about him because he was a stand-up dude. He was like, yo, and plus the gift baskets work. Yeah, the gift baskets.
Gift
work.
Baskets, NDAs,
NDAs, and gift baskets definitely take you a long way. Yeah. But kind of shoveling into this, what do you think about the next hot take segment? Is LeBron's 40K? What do you think about that?
So LeBron's 40K is more so. I mean, shout out to LeBron James.
Shout out to LeBron.
He's just smashing every statistical category there is.
Yeah.
I feel like how it was kind of celebrated, I feel like they should have called a timeout and let him have his moment, you know?
But they already did that when he broke, Kareem's record. They already did that.
True, but 40K is a milestone.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
but and if I'm him, I would have been like, yo, toss, kick that ball out. Like, yo, let's,
My take was on it, okay, like the NBA is definitely going to celebrate him when it's time for him to retire. 1,000%. Oh, that goes absolutely without saying. There's debates about whether MJ or him are the GOAT. He's definitely this generation's GOAT. That's unquestioned, right? Yeah. Nobody's come close to him. But at what point does it stop? What if he hits 41K? That's a new milestone. Every point after this point is going to be a milestone. So do we stop? Like, what? I feel like if he hits 50,000, which he won't get to unless he plays another 10 years, right? Or 45K, which I guess can kind of happen if he plays 5 more years. I don't know how likely that is. But at what point? I don't think the game should have been stopped. I think at halftime they should have done something for him. I think, which they did. I think they did something at halftime. I think that was more appropriate. Stopping the game. I mean, at what point does it stop getting, okay, like he's already breaking all statistical records. Like, are we going to stop it at 41, too, at 42, 43, 44? Like something has to stop. So, and with him, I think with LeBron, what he has shown is that consistency, work, perseverance, man, that's the only dude in my generation who's had so many expectations. And he's met every expectation placed on an 18-year-old kid to be the greatest. Think about that.
It's a storybook.
That's why when he pops off now, I don't even say anything. Because he actually said, and there's people who want him to fail.
Yeah.
You remember in his speech, in his 40K speech, he's like, there's so many people that even aside from his mom and his people around him, Maverick Carter, Rich Paul, and all these other people around him, there's people who want him to fail.
Yeah, yeah.
Who's him to be Don the greatest? Especially when you had right before him, Kobe, Shaq, MJ.
Yep.
Larry and Bird, Magic, like this guy's gonna come in with all this clout and kind of reeling it back to the podcast. There needs to be a certain humbleness, but also confident, delusional confidence that we need to have in ourselves, right? Yeah. Because you always need to kind of balance that a little bit. Because we need to be confident in ourselves. We always need to know our place, right? I'm not gonna go and be like, I'm the next Joe Rogan podcast. There's a lot of work that needs to be done. Joe Rogan had a whole career. I'm only using Joe Rogan because he's the most recognized name and he's the biggest podcast, and that's a statistical fact. when it comes to podcasting. He had a whole career before that. Yeah. He put in so much work. So LeBron put in so much damn work to get to where he's at today.
Exactly. And that confidence comes with just, you know, like if you equate this to sports, just practice and all that. And we just started. But I know the work we're putting in. I know the investment that we're doing. And it's like, we're getting to that point, or I mean, not so soon, but we know what we're putting in. So we're, yeah, we're definitely going to have that perseverance to keep going.
Exactly. All right. Yeah. It's transitioning over, man. So what do you feel about you? I know that you've been blabbing my ear about this person. TikTok star. So TikTok star Teresa Johnson has signed with CA for representation. Right. So always, for those of you who don't know, she's the one who did the 50 part series on TikTok. Who the F did I marry? And it's literally taken over the social waves. Everyone's talking about it. I saw a 20-minute synopsis of what it's about, and I feel like I know this person a lot. But just to give everybody a little bit of context, the TikTok series has earned over 400 million impressions in under 3 weeks, making her an overnight success. The online videos, which debuted on TikTok on February 14th, recall her marriage to and split from who she claimed to be is a pathological liar. So what do you think about her signing to CAA? What do you think about her overnight success? What do you think about her storytelling? What's your hot take?
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's one, I did catch quite a few episodes of the Who the F Did I Marry, and it's entertaining. Her ability to just storytell, it should be a Netflix movie or something like that, because I'll definitely watch. I know millions of others will watch as well.
If we could watch Love is Blind, we could watch this.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I seen something online that said, for our generation, us watching reality TV is equal to kids watching other people play video games.
That's true. That's true, man. That's true. You're seeing other people doing it, right?
Yeah.
And what this, and I guess my hot take is on this is congratulations to her.
Shout out
to Risa Tisa for doing this, right?
Because if her story is true, I mean, she been through a lot. And this is
only justice that she signed up to CAA, right? Yeah. So now she's about to get that deal.
Get that bag.
Get that bag.
The book deal, the movie deal.
Get everything.
I'm all for it if it's true and all that. My question to you as a lawyer, I don't know if this is your field or not, but I mean, does she risk getting sued by can you just out someone like that in public and social media?
Not my area of law. I do corporate and transactional law. I don't really get into like defamation and things that kind of can go on to this, right? But if what she's saying is true, then she has nothing to worry about, right? Yeah. But if what she's saying, if the guy is saying what he's saying, or her ex-husband, I don't know who this guy is, right? Is saying like, you're defaming me. That's pretty a uphill battle to begin with already to prove. But you know, you shouldn't be out here defaming people, right? Just for your own success. I don't think she's doing that, because the amount of detail, it seemed like she really did suffer through this with this guy and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And there's also too much proof and too much evidence that the other guy was kind of not, not who he's saying he was. But at the end of the day, hey, like.
And even the format of TikTok, it's not really for long format videos.
Yeah, I mean,
and how it took off, that's astonishing in itself.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, and that just goes to show, when it comes to just creating content, because what she did was she created content, is if a story's intriguing, if what you're talking about people want to hear, like, it doesn't matter if it's short, long, there's no algorithm to it.
No, people like messy though.
Yeah.
People like messy.
We're in a toxic society now.
People like toxicity. We can go ahead and be like, we're so successful. We want to do this positive message is that. Yeah, that gets us clicks, but there's nothing that gets it clicked like a good old toxic clickbait, right? So at the end of the day, she's speaking her truth and she's able to profit out of it. I'm not against that. That's great.
Yeah.
Go ahead and profit off your truth. Yeah. So that's my hot take. My hot take is I'm happy for her. It was highly entertaining for millions of people. And we'll see what's next. She's an incredibly talented storyteller. So now with CEA, she's probably gonna get with a real team to she has raw talent. So now she needs to polish it.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, man, that's our hot take session. Please let us know in the comments what else you want to hear about, because we actually want to make this as part of our show, something
that we
can get to you as soon as possible. Something that I know our listeners have to wait months sometimes to create another episode. So just let us know what you think.
All right.
All right. See you
Peace.
Later.